NBA is downright business. Everyone knows that. As a player, you can never be sure of your future. You can be a star one day, get an injury, and then get passed around like a bad pizza. There are a lot of trades in the league every year, and while earlier in the league history player trades weren't as frequent, they still happened. In fact, in the 80s, there was this one weird trade, which I'm going to talk about today. Hello, hope all my watchers are doing well. I'm Purple Prince, and if you still haven't and want to brighten up my day, press that subscribe button. Did it? Thanks. Now let's get to business. First of all, congratulations and happy birthday to Fred Roberts, the hero of today's story. He was born on this day, August 14th, exactly 58 years ago, in 1960. Fred Roberts was drafted in 1982 NBA draft, number 27 overall, by Milwaukee Bucks, but wanted to stay another year in Italy and play there. While he was there, he was traded to New Jersey Nets for Phil Ford and a second round pick, and then got traded to San Antonio Spurs for coach Stan Albeck. That was only the start of weirdness though. Roberts played only one full season with the Spurs, averaging 7.3 points and 3.8 rebounds in just under 20 minutes per game. During the next season, he was traded to Utah Jazz for 2 second round picks. He played in Utah till 1986, averaging classic reserve numbers, about 6 points and 2 rebounds per game. After the season, now that's when the weirdness happened. Fred Roberts became a restricted free agent. With the unfortunate passing of Len Bias, Boston needed a quality big man. And even though Fred Roberts wasn't considered quality by a lot of teams, he did appeal to Boston. Roberts didn't receive many offers, but the Celtics did wish to see him on their team. They offered Roberts a 2-year offer sheet for around $400,000. The Jazz didn't really need Roberts because they had Karl Malone, but Utah Jazz front office wanted to get a second round pick in return for Roberts, so they matched the offer sheet. By the rules, Fred Roberts would stay with the Utah Jazz, but that's when the weirdness started. Celtics still wanted Roberts and Utah still wanted a second round pick, but the Celtics didn't have any second round picks in the upcoming drafts. Utah Jazz wouldn't accept the 4th round pick they were offered by the Celtics. After long talks, eventually, Fred Roberts was traded to Boston Celtics for a 3rd round pick and 2 preseason games. Yes, you heard that right, 2 preseason games. Celtics agreed to play 2 exhibition games in Utah. Why? Well, the question remains unanswered, but I think Utah front office understood that Boston had star players in Larry Bird, Kevin McHale, and Robert Parrish, so they decided that it would boost ticket sales for their preseason games. Pretty smart. Fred Roberts would just play 2 years with the Celtics, averaging about 6 points and 2.5 rebounds per game, before being taken in the expansion draft by the Miami Heat. He wouldn't even suit up for the Heat before being traded once again, this time back to the team that originally drafted him, the Milwaukee Bucks. Fun fact, after joining the Bucks in 1982, Milwaukee head coach Del Harris said, "I have promised Fred that if we ever trade him, it will be for a human being." That should have been a relief. And actually, that's a good thing to promise, since he was traded for a coach and 2 exhibition games previously. After all the weirdness, Fred Roberts would move on to have his best 5 seasons as a pro, playing for Milwaukee Bucks. He even cracked the 10 points per game mark twice during the 5 seasons in Milwaukee. After his contract ended, Roberts would go to Spain and play there for a year. Then, he signed a 10-day contract with Cleveland Cavaliers, but injuries forced Cavs to sign him for the whole season, and he played around 10 minutes per game for the team. He would also make short stops in Los Angeles and Dallas before calling it quits during the 96-97 season. Fred Roberts ended his NBA career averaging 7.3 points and 2.8 rebounds, and he can surely say that he has been a part of some of the weirdest trades in NBA history. That's all for today. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Do you know any other weird NBA trades that happened recently or way back in the days? Please leave a comment below, like this video, and subscribe for future NBA content. I'll see you soon. This was Purple Prince, and I'm out.
We get aggressive, you be undressing, making a mess, cleaning it up when we done. I got a serious question. Do you like sex? If you thinking yes, then I'm trying to test you. Say Uncle Khalifa the best, but I got money to get. I gotta hop on the jet.